Dear students, welcome to our class on visit to the Madras Glass Laboratory. Here in this very short presentation, we are going to see how a Madras Glass Laboratory looks like. Now, before we go to the actual class, let us have a small quote only to inspire you. What is it? Be strong, but not rude. Be kind, but not weak. Be humble, but not timid. Be proud but not arrogant. This is the quote for today's class. Now, so let us go into the small presentation of how a Madras observatory looks like. Usually, the size of the observatory has to be decided depending upon the number of instruments to be installed. The general recommendation for the size of the plot is 54 meters north south by 36 meters east west for an agrometer observatory, 25 meters north south by 15 meters east west for other purposes. So this is how a meteorological observatory looks like. Now I would like to impress upon you that in an observatory, what all the instruments that we see in the surface observatory are perfectly and on dot information, they go on recording as per the standard timings, local apron time, local mean time, Indian standard time as far as India is concerned. For other globes, you know, so this is a standard measure of all the surface instruments measurement, recording and transmitted to the concerned sections for weather forecasting purposes and also for several uses of weather information. Now you are seeing, of course, self-recording range is this one. Okay, so this is how the USWB open pan open meter looks. Now let us go and then see the other instrument that is usually present in surface observatory, that is the double Stevenson's thing, in which there is a thermograph, bimetallic thermograph, where two dissimilar metals are which are having different coefficient of expansion. One end is fixed and the other end is connected to a lever mechanism and a pen. It records. The other one is the hair hygrograph. So here also the air, expansion and contraction of air because of the changes in the humidity are conveyed to a lever mechanism, and it is attached to the pendulum which records on a rotating the humidity continuously, because this is the air hygrograph. So it records the instruments available in a surface observatory. Now, before I end the class, I would like to impress upon you, it is this is the book what we call it as the Guide to Agricultural Meteorological Practices, GAMP of World Meteorological Organization, Geneva, Switzerland, for which I wrote chapter 2 in this year. This is the chapter 2 of WMO number 134, chapter 2 of WMO 134. I am very happy. I have coordinated with innumerable scientists across the globe, and I led the team as far as chapter 2 of GAMP, usually in other countries called as GAMP, GAMP, GAMP. Okay, so it was a very hard work for over a decade. I am able to write chapter 2 in this. It has my colleagues are from all the continents. So in this, I had given very good view of very good presentation of agrometeorological observatories that I am going to tell in the PG and PhD classes when they are coming. So till such time, this is the basic course. Just for the beginners, I have given the presentation. Thanking you very much. May God bless you.